Abraham was thinking only about his own life. He was thinking of how he's going to save his life. He was thinking about himself. He did not think about his wife. What time is it? It's Revelation O'Clock. Auntie Z here, welcome back to my channel. It's another edition of Revelation O'Clock, a moment when we take time or spend time in digging deep into the Word of God to find out those truths that are going to shape us into the godly women and men after God's own heart that He so desires. So, welcome, Ali Salomu na Auntie Z. If you've been new for this channel, na Auntie Z with this. Ali talk anyone with mama mom. Whether na English or whether na French or whether na Pidgin, come on. So, welcome to Revelation O'Clock, Moments of Truth with the Word of God with Auntie Z. So for today, we want to talk about keeping your salvation. I want to let you know, spoil your salvation, Sika Man Pidgin. No risk your salvation, Sika Man Pidgin. And why I talk so? The Word of God we want to share and today come up from Genesis chapter 12 from verses 10 to 20. The Bible says, now there was a famine in the land, and Abram went down to Egypt to live there for a while because the famine was severe. As he was about to enter Egypt, he said to his wife Sarai, "I know what a beautiful woman you are. When the Egyptians see you, they will say, 'This is his wife.' Then they will kill me but will let you live. Say you are my sister, so that I will be treated well for your sake, and my life will be spared because of you." So we'll just stop there for a moment. To give you a small recap, Abraham had been sent away from his homeland by God. God had made him a sevenfold promise. He said, "I'm going to show you a land that is flowing with milk and honey. I'm going to make you great. I'm going to make a great nation out of you." You know, so Abraham takes his wife, takes his nephew Lot, and starts following the instructions that God has given him. You know, God had shown himself to Abraham, and Abraham was in communication with God. So now the Bible is telling us that that there was a famine in the land. And so Abraham decides now to go down to Egypt to live there for a while. If he finds job. So he don't go now and go enter Egypt, realize, say, these people are like this, they will surely do something to me because the way I'm seeing, my life is in danger. So what am I going to do? He tells his wife, "Lie that I am your brother, lie that you are my sister, so that when we get there, my life will be spared." Now, this is where I just want to stop for a moment. Let us think about it for a minute. Don't you see that Abraham is a little bit egoistic here? The Bible tells us in verses 13 that, "Say you are my sister." Why? "So that I, Abraham, will be treated well for your sake. And my life, whose life? Abraham's life will be spared because of you." So this is Abraham telling his wife to tell a lie. We all know that God does not want us to lie. Lies, many people use this verse and say Abraham also lied. Let me tell you something. God does not want us to lie. If he has given you a mission and a vision and he wants you to walk a certain path, you should walk that path, but it doesn't include disobeying him or doing things that are against his will to reach your destination. You understand? And that is what most of us do. Some of us come to Europe with funny papers and come here and start lying and so on. And then you will hear pastors saying that God is going to give you this land as a possession. So go and lie that this is wrong. You know, this is wrong. So this is what Abraham tells his wife. His life is in danger. He's afraid for his life. Somehow or somewhere along the line, I feel that he has even lost a little bit of faith in the person who called him out of the land of Ur to the land where God is sending him. And now he sees that his life is in danger and then thinks only about himself. So if his life is in danger, his wife's life is not also in danger. Why be so, you know, think about his life? Why be saying, "No, me na hito say, ama alai say, me a be a brother." Why he send a woman for front? Why? Because he want to protect his own life. He says, "So that they will spare my life." What about the woman? So you are sending this woman to go and putting her in a dangerous position, not thinking about her, thinking only about yourself. And on top of that, you are sending her to do something that is against the will of God. And so the Bible tells us, goes further to let us know that Sarah does what her husband tells her to do. Somewhere we see her loyalty to her husband. We see that she wants to protect her husband's life. She doesn't want something to happen to her husband. So she decides to tell a lie. You understand? And now we don't see her now say, Pharaoh, if people don't see this beautiful woman, they say, aye, this woman feels sweet for our Pharaoh very well. Make me take it, go give her. Now so Abraham, they spare a life. But waiting for happen if this woman went and slept with Pharaoh. Waiting for happen if this woman was raped by Pharaoh's guards. Abraham did not think about all of that. He was only thinking about his own life. He was thinking of how he's going to save his life. He was thinking about himself. He did not think about his wife. Maybe he forgot. Maybe he was egoistic. I don't know what happened. But that's exactly what happens even in our own lives today. Most of these people who send us to go and do things that are against the will of God, they are not thinking about you. They don't care about their salvation. They just want to satisfy their own selves and satisfy their own desires, you know. So we know that God had told Abraham that I am going to make a great nation out of you. And he was meaning out of Abraham and Sarai. He did not include Pharaoh. Pharaoh no be any sign for inside the picture. But now, see Pharaoh don't can go take Sarai. And so verse 17 tells us that what? But the Lord inflicted serious diseases on Pharaoh and his household because of Abraham's wife Sarai. The Lord was not going to let that happen. God said, lie, this plan will not make a day so. You will not be included for inside this palaver. So stay out of the way. If it means that I will inflict you disease, I will inflict you disease on you and your household because my plan must come to pass. And we know that Jesus Christ is a descendant from here. So this is how the devil comes and tries to interfere with God's plan for our lives, especially when we want to try to take things into our own hands. When we start to fear, when we are in front of a situation that causes us to fear, that causes us to forget God's promises. God had given Abraham a sevenfold promise. He needed to remember that God is with me. If God had spoken to me back in Ur, then in Egypt, with the severe famine, with the fact that these people might hurt my life, he needed to remember that God was always present and submit everything to him, knowing that God had a plan that he needed to accomplish. Okay, one other thing I want to share with you people is that most of the time it is so. When you want to do things when they out of the will of God, we forget the consequences then they. Say people then they for our surrounding where they will suffer the consequence of our walking out of the will of God. The Bible tell we say, because this thing happened, so Abraham do it, he received plenty cattle. That's verse 16. He treated Abraham well for her sake, and Abraham acquired sheep and cattle, male and female donkeys, male and female servants and clients. You see, number one, if you read the chapters ahead, you go realize quickly, say, Abraham and Lot, that means Abraham and nephew, they can't go get quarrel, seek a plenty cargo. This cargo will come off of Egypt, number one. Number two, among the female servants, the way Abraham acquired for Egypt, we be Hagar be there inside, and now Hagar can go born picking with Abraham. When he be a picking, when he not be picking of the promise. You see, number three, the Bible tell us say God inflicted serious diseases on not only Pharaoh but also on his household. So our sins and our disobedience and walking out of the will of God and doing things that are out of the precepts of God brings a lot of problem. That one thing where you want to do so because you want to please your husband, you want to please pastor, you want to please your surrounding, you want to please your mommy, when you know very well, say, be against the will of God. When it will happen, say, it will bring you trouble. It will bring you trouble. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't lose your salvation because of your husband. If your husband tells you that, go and steal. Or maybe your husband, therefore, in some ministry, the world will take bribe. He bring bribe. You and you, and she don't chop. Man, I tell you something. Consequences are coming, you know. Consequences are coming because you yourself will know that this thing is not correct. No, follow your husband, lose your salvation. The Bible is asking us not to lie, not to steal, not to do things. No, follow your wife, lose your salvation. Because any one of these days will stand up from God, will go give an account of the way we will not live our life. God is not going to say, oh, it's because it's your husband that sent you. God is not going, the proof is that even to Abraham, because many people like to use this verse as an example that even Abraham, who was the father of faith, lied. If you read the chapters ahead, you will realize that God told Abraham that walk in front of my face and be faithful. Walk in front of me and be just. He was telling him that, look, those errors that you committed before, don't do them again. That lie that you told before, don't do it again. Walk now and be correct. Walk correctly in front of me. You understand? So this is the word I wanted to share with you today. Don't lose your salvation because of your husband. Don't lose your salvation because of your husband. No. Don't follow Oga and go and do something that God does not like. Don't follow him. Because at the end of the day, when two of you will be standing, it will not more be Madam and Mr. and Mrs. It will be you alone. Any man will stand up for front, Papa God, talk his own, give account as well, you don't live your life. Papa God knows, say now because your man saying you, now because your woman saying you, now because you want please mommy or papa, now because you mean your pastor. No follow pastor, go for inside water. No follow pastor, go do see what God no like because you're a pastor. So my friends, this is it for this moment of truth with Auntie Z. The Lord wants to let us know that we shouldn't lose our salvation because of someone. Do not love someone so much that you go against the precepts of God, go against his will and walk out of his ways because of someone. At the end of the day, we all are going to stand face to face before our Lord and give an account for our lives. Know that what he promised he's going to do, he's going to take you through. Even in the valley, he would be there. On the mountaintop, he's going to be there. In the days that he's going to be there, all he wants of you is that you rely on him, trust him. Know that he's a God that is the beginning and the end. He starts and he finishes. So he's not going to abandon you in Egypt. He's not going to abandon you in the face of adversity. He's not going to abandon you in front of those pharaohs. I want you to choose to obey God and walk in his ways instead of man. So Auntie Z is saying thank you for watching. If you love this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share it with your friends. There's somebody out there who might need a word of encouragement. And remember, God loves you always. I'm going to see you in my next video.